You know, cars and trucks like this sure make our lives a whole lot easier. But they can also place us in harm's way.
I'd like to tell you a story about a hardworking couple whose lives were changed forever when they got in one of these on their way to work one morning.
It was a day like any other day. Getting ready for work, morning rush, making sandwiches. Getting in the car just to hit the road to be at work on time. Conversation, kids, bills, future. Conversation like you and I would have. Their names are Thomas and Danielle. And in a split second, their ordinary day became extraordinary in a very horrible way. Little did they know of the profound effects the events of this morning would have in their lives and how their lives began to literally spiral out of control. They both lost their jobs. They had no health insurance. And what heirlooms and precious things they did have, they began to sell just to make ends meet. They were damaged physically and emotionally. Future plans, gone. It was confusing, and there was a thick fog of uncertainty and confusion.
Before the accident, life was normal. I went to work at 7 a.m. I was a mechanic at a local tire shop. I spent a lot of time with the family, outside playing with my dogs, throwing the ball, getting in the hot tub and swimming. I was a student at the University of Akron. You know, Danielle and I were living the normal life that most people live.
Our hopes and dreams were to watch our children grow up and welcome our grandchildren.
The morning our lives changed, things were very normal. Danielle was packing my lunch for work, making fried egg sandwiches, getting our coffee and our to-go cups ready to go. We rode to work together in order to save a little money.
So we proceeded to leave that morning, and we're driving down the road that we always drive down, Wadsworth-Rittman Road, and a car I saw out of the corner of my eye was not stopping once he reached the stop sign, and he stopped right in front of us.
We pretty much had two choices. We could hit him head on or swerve into the ditch. Swerved, we missed his vehicle, we hit the street sign, the county sign, a whole bunch of signs, and went straight into the ditch. The impact, the glass all over us, airbags off, Danielle crying in horrible pain, and I was so charged and amped up from the adrenaline that I couldn't even recognize any injuries that I sustained myself. As the accident happened, I look over, Danielle's just got tears coming down her face. She's in excruciating pain. I have glass all over me. I wanted to make sure the other driver was safe as well. So I told Danielle I'd be right back. I got out of the car. And I went to make sure the other driver was okay. The paramedics, the fire department, and the police all showed up at the same scene around the same time. Danielle was taken out of the car and put onto a stretcher. I was totally worried about her. I mean, I knew she was crying the minute it happened, but I didn't know what was wrong with her.
I remember every single bump that the ambulance hit. I could just feel it in my back, the pain. It was horrible. I just kept saying, ow, 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 that hurts, you know, and they were like, you know, couldn't figure out what was going on with me. It was just one of the worst car rides I've ever had. Not really car rides, but ambulance. I've never been in an ambulance, but that was bad.
I first arrived at the hospital into the emergency area, and I was so nervous and scared. I mean, the woman that I love with all my heart and soul was in there, and I didn't know what was wrong with her, and I didn't know how I could help her. It was to the point where I was still ignoring what was wrong with me and what was going on with me, but I was totally concerned with what was wrong with her. I talked to the lady at the front desk, and they said that we couldn't go back yet because Danielle was going to be taken in for x-rays. So we had to wait in the waiting area, and I just remember that it felt like forever until I could go and be with her and hold her hand and be there to comfort her. I had never been in an accident before in my life. I mean, this was all such a new experience to me. And I felt like if I did anything wrong, that maybe I wouldn't be able to get compensated for my car or get Danielle the help that she needed. So I decided that I needed to look for someone to help me. I got on the internet and I started reading reviews of law firms. And I found one, and they said that this guy, their lawyer, was treated them like family. And that's what I wanted. I wanted someone that could help me, that wouldn't take advantage of me, that wouldn't be beside Danielle's bed at the hospital trying to get her to sign papers and, you know, the stuff that you see in TVs about attorneys that do accidents. I was very, very afraid. And I found one and I called him. And he told me to take care of Danielle first. He told me that health was the number one thing to get better. I was shocked. I just couldn't believe it. Here he's not trying to take advantage of me or get me in to sign papers or anything. He's telling me get better.
The next morning after the accident, I woke up and I was in excruciating pain, and Thomas had explained everything, how he found an attorney, and the attorney recommended us to go to see a doctor, and that we had an appointment that morning. I didn't know how I was gonna get up and get dressed to even go, because, you know, the pain in my back was just so intense that even the little drugs that they did give me, send me home with from the hospital, just really were not doing it.
We proceeded to the doctor's office the next morning, and at that point I was in excruciating pain. I could hardly move my left arm, my shoulder, my neck hurt, my back hurt. I was just aching all over. So I went back to work after a couple days, but I couldn't do it. And we were finally taken to pain management, where they started doing epidural shots, which they would actually numb your sciatic nerve. And that helped me. It helped me be able to work. But Dr. said that I couldn't work. He said that with my injury that I could only make my back worse and that I needed to get better. And Danielle, she did physical therapy with her clients. She couldn't lift these people or roll these people over or do any kind of work that was physical like that. She could barely walk on her own. So she was out of work. She actually was able to go back to the receptionist job, but because of her having to go to the doctors three times a week, her boss said it would be better if they went their separate ways. So at this point, we're both out of work. We don't know what to do. We're scared. We're nervous. We were left where we had to start liquidating all our assets.
I was just kind of in shock of everything that was going on. I couldn't believe that this had happened to us and that neither one of us could work. I didn't know where, you know, our money was going to come from to pay our rent, for food. We didn't have insurance, so I was worried about that. When we finally did get to the attorney's office, he was wonderful. Mr. Slater, he explained everything to us, explained how the process works. After my consultation with him, I felt so much better. He was upfront with us and honest with us about everything.
So I went to Slater's and Zurz's law office, and the first thing I was impressed is that they were at the penthouse suite of this huge building, and they had this wonderful law office. And I was like, wow, these are the people that are going to be backing me up. And I felt confident in knowing that he was going to be the one that was helping us. Getting into his office, he made a few phone calls. He actually talked to the insurance company of the man who caused the accident. So Mr. Slater had some kind of idea of what was going to happen. I was in shock. I couldn't believe it. He told me, Thomas, don't worry about anything. Just get better. Just your health is number one. You guys go heal. Go get better. I'll handle everything. I felt very comfortable with that. Here's a man sitting on the other side, and all he's worried about is our health. That made me extremely happy. Another thing that Mr. Slater did for us was he called some physicians. We didn't have health insurance. There was no Affordable Health Care Act at the time of our accident. He actually got not just any doctors, but very qualified, expert neurosurgeons to look at our cases and to help us.
So after we left his office, Thomas and I were driving home in the car, and we were, you know, just going back and forth about, you know, how we totally love this attorney and that he made us feel so comfortable and so we knew exactly what the whole procedure was going to be. He explained everything in detail, which made me feel a lot better. I told Thomas, I'm like, good job on picking a good attorney. I think we have a good one here.
Not only did I find out that I had this wonderful one attorney, but I had a team of attorneys who analyzed and dissected our case and our claim. Rick Zurz totally came into the picture and introduced himself to us as a partner in the law firm. And Mike Smeltzer was our trial lawyer. We had a team of attorneys who was taking care of us. Not just one really nice guy who could be my father, but we had a very professional staff working this long drawn out process. Mr. Slater did explain to us that we had 2 years to file a claim. And we had never been in a car accident. We didn't know what was going to happen or how long it would take or anything. But he said, in 2 years, we hope that you'll have enough medical treatment and that you'll heal enough to know where you're at. And in the medical field, things take time. You have to go to one appointment and you have to get this done. Then you have to go to another appointment and get this done. And then you have to go to get testing. And then you have to wait for a schedule. And then you need a surgeon. And so it's a long, drawn out process that takes time. And that's one thing that our attorneys were there 100% for us. Mr. Slater would just call us out of the blue and ask how we were doing. You know, hey, how's your health? What's going on? How's Danielle? Here's this attorney who just cares about our well-being. And if I had an issue, I would tell him, you know, and then he would comfort and console me. and help me get through even the roughest patch. During this huge ordeal, we had no income. We had only the assets that we had saved for and built up our whole life. We had a PERS retirement account. We had three vehicles. We had to sell two of them. We had to get rid of family heirlooms that had been our family for years. And we had to do this to survive on a monthly basis. The whole time, Mr. Slater was assuring me that it was going to be okay, that he was going to help us through it, that we would get our stuff back, and that we'd be able to have our retirement again one day, and that not to worry about it, just make it and get better. He said the main important thing is that we just get our health back. And I couldn't really understand. Here I am sad about losing cars, and he's telling me, just get healthy, and then we're going to take care of everything else. And that was huge for us.
The day that it finally came that we were actually going to be getting a settlement and that we had reached an agreement, it was actually kind of funny because we were out of town, and I was playing phone tag with my attorney, Mike Schmelzer, back and forth, and we were negotiating on the phone. He would call me back and say they came back with this, and then, you know, it finally that we were able to get the max policy. I was excited. I was just like, oh my gosh, finally, after almost 3 years of struggling, of, you know, what we have gone through, finally, we're seeing a light at the end of the tunnel. We know that things are going to start to look better for us financially. And that couldn't have been a better feeling.
We were never promised anything. That was one thing that the law firm never said, well, we're going to get you this or we're going to get you that. We were never promised anything except that we would be treated fair. To me, that is all I wanted. I just wanted fair treatment. And that meant a lot to me.
I might not ever be able to work again. So planning for my future and taking this money and making sure that this money is going to be there for me during retirement is so crucial for me.
I just want everyone to know how thorough that this Slater and Zurz is with trying to help you with everything, not just your law case. That's only one part of it. There's the health, there's the planning after, there's all these parts of your case that you don't even think of that they got your back on, that they are covering you on. Now, today, I'm thinking about reestablishing that retirement account that we lost. I'm looking for new vehicles because now I can finally afford one. And we're looking for a nice house, and we want a fenced yard, and I mean, it's just everything that we lost, we'll be able to get it back and more. We've made friends with our attorneys. We feel confident in the relationship that we have with them, and it's just awesome.
I think when you think of an attorney, especially an attorney that deals with accidents, you think all they're out for is the money. All they care about is how much money can they get from this accident. I never once felt that Slater and Zurz was out for the money. I always felt like they cared more about me as a person, rather than my actual accident. Even though behind the scenes, they worked diligently and very, very hard to get us the maximum amount of money that we could get. Their bedside manner was just extraordinary. I feel like Mr. Slater has been a friend of mine for years. You know, always gives me a hug when he sees me. You don't think of attorneys doing that. you don't think of them as being friends. You think of them as, you know, rigid and uptight and not really caring about you as a person, caring more about the money. And I did not feel like Slater and Zurz did that at all.
You know, before I got on the phone to research an attorney, you know, I just kept flashing in my mind all the movie things, how you're at the hospital and here's this lawyer trying to get you to sign a piece of paper and here's this guy that's trying to get you. I kept thinking of it. And after dealing with the law office of Slater and Zurz, I don't have that preconceived notion anymore. I don't even think that that's how attorneys are. They've totally changed my mind and my heart and everything because of the way that they handled me. They were so kind and compassionate and caring and planning and just, I mean, there were so many things that I never thought an attorney would be. Family. That's the best way I can describe it. It's the experience that you'll receive, or that I received, was top notch.
When you've been involved in an accident, you need lawyers who sincerely care about you, professionals who will protect your best interests, and most of all, a law firm with experience and skills that deliver clients the compensation they will need to restore the hopes and dreams that were destroyed in an accident. That law firm is Slater and Zurz. They will work tirelessly to make sure you receive both the care and the compensation you need for the injuries and damages you can see as well as the ones you can't see. Contact Slater and Zurz at any time for a free, no obligation consultation by calling 1-800-297-9191 or send us a message through our website at slaterzurz.com. That's SlaterZurz.com.